Hi folks, and welcome to Travel Spree, brought to you by Inspiring Vacations. My name is Scott Ellis, I'm the National Sales Manager for Travel Marvel, and thrilled to showcase what has to be the most beautiful destination in the world, which is of course, Canada and Alaska. For those of you not familiar with Travel Marvel, we're part of the APT family, and APT celebrates over 90 years of travel. 90 years of experience bringing Australians to all around the world experiencing this magnificent planet that we have to offer. Travel Marvel represents the best value holidays you can get. Having fantastic premium accommodation, premium occlusions, exclusive insights into different destinations, but also balancing that with the right amount of free time. So you've got the great balance of the inclusions, camaraderie, the group travel, but also having time to discover these destinations at your own pace, and including everything that you want to do along the way too. Folks, we're going to talk today about the breathtaking scenery, magnificent mountain ranges, the emerald-coloured lakes, the wildlife of Canada and Alaska, and some of the great itineraries and experiences available for you in North America. So let's have a little bit of an overview here. So when you have a look at the east coast of Canada, we have tours that feature Toronto, Niagara, Ottawa, Montreal, Quebec. We then can combine that with the Holland America cruise around to Boston, featuring Prince Edward Island, Anne of Green Gables, Halifax, Nova Scotia, and seeing that rich maritime history of the East Coast. You've got a little town there called Churchill, right in the middle there. Churchill is where you'd go if you'd like to see the polar bears. So if you've got a real interest in the polar bears, we would fly you from Vancouver to Winnipeg and Winnipeg straight up to Churchill there. So not only would you see the polar bears, but you might also try and see the beluga whales. So the white whales, and they're found in Hudson Bay. So right there next to Churchill. If you'd like to discover Alaska in depth, then I would recommend a cruise from Vancouver up into Alaska and then an extension into the Denali National Park. The Denali National Park is where you'd experience magnificent mountain ranges and also some of those North American animals like caribou, moose, elk, bears, deers, bald eagles, dull sheep, all of those fabulous North American animals. But really, most of our clients, what they're really looking for when they think Canada for the first time is this West Coast. And this itinerary here, the Reflections of the Rockies and Alaska Cruise, is a fabulous itinerary to showcase to you the beauty of Canada and Alaska. We'd start off in Victoria, located on Vancouver Island there. And one of the highlights that we'll experience is the Butchart Gardens. Over 100 years old, the Butchart Gardens are more than just a garden. They're like it's almost like an art exhibit only made of flowers and plants. It is quite an extraordinary experience to walk the Butchart Gardens. We'll then go up to Whistler, spend two nights up in the Whistler Village. Our accommodation located right in the village there, perfect location to be able to walk around Whistler. You can go and do a chairlift if you'd like, and which takes you right up to the top of the Whistler range there with stunning views. We go to Blue River, and this is a great experience for me. We stay at the Mike Wiggell Resort here, which is in a fantastic natural environment. And we're going to do a cruise up the Blue River. The Blue River cruise boasts some fantastic scenery, real insight into the rainforest here. You may even see a bear if you're lucky, but particularly focused around that rainforest type of experience that you can get there. This is actually one of the only inland temperate rainforests in the world. Moving from Blue River, we now come into Jasper. And this is the start of spending 6 days, 5 nights in the Canadian Rockies. We spent two nights there at Jasper, and one of the great highlights of this region is the Athabasca Glacier. Located on the Columbian ice fields, the Athabasca Glacier is one of the most visited glaciers in all of North America. And for Travel Marvel clients, we actually get on a specially designed snow coach and we ride on the glacier. Once we get up into the middle of the glacier, you're going to have the opportunity to step out and walk on the glacier right there in the middle. Traveling from Jasper down to Lake Louise, that area there is nicknamed the Glacier Highway. So visibly from the road today, you'll see over 100 different glaciers. We spend the night in Lake Louise and we do have a treat for you. We'll be staying at the Chateau Lake Louise tonight. And then we make our way from Lake Louise down to Banff. That section there is where you'll see all the emerald coloured lakes, Peyto Lake, Moraine Lake, and of course Lake Louise. All of these emerald coloured lakes are glacier fed. So what will happen at the start of the season is that there'll be a little bit of a melting from the glaciers. And with that runoff, it takes a natural chemical element called rock flour. And that rock flour is then present in the water for the season. And when the sun bounces off the lake, that's where you see this emerald colour, which is just extraordinary. And you'll see so many photos before you go, but until you see it for your own eyes, you just can't even imagine how beautiful that emerald coloured lake is. We then spent 2 nights in Banff, located, of course, in the Banff National Park there, before joining the Rocky Mountaineer, for which what has to be the best way to highlight the beautiful Canadian wilderness on board this iconic train journey. We travelled from Banff to Kamloops. We overnighted in Kamloops, spending the night in the accommodation. Then the second day is Kamloops around to Vancouver there. We spent 2 days in Vancouver before we board our 7-night cruise of Holland America. So the cruise of Alaska, it's known as the Inside Passage, because as you can see by this map here, you're not really in exposed water. You are inside. So you're in sheltered waters for the majority of the cruise. So some of the ports that we'll visit, Juneau. Juneau is the capital of Alaska. Juneau is a landlocked city, only accessible by air or by sea. So there are no roads that lead out of Juneau. Juneau is most well known for the Mendenhall Glacier. So today you might like to go and have a look at the Mendenhall Glacier. Skagway is the home of the 1800s gold rush. So today you might like to take a train ride through the White Pass Mountains into the Yukon. And it was in the Yukon where they panned for gold. So you could have an experience of that era. Glacier Bay, without doubt for me, was the highlight of my cruise. With Holland America, we get priority access to into Glacier Bay. And on my cruises, I've spent up to 12 hours cruising all the different fjords of Glacier Bay. The highlight was definitely Marjorie. Marjorie Glacier is the biggest glacier of Glacier Bay. It is enormous, but what makes it unique is that it is actually advancing. So where 95% of glaciers in the world are receding, Marjorie Glacier is actually advancing. So you'll park the Holland America, or you won't park it, but the Holland America will be parked right in front of Marjorie, and you'll actually be able to hear the ice carving, so the cracks of the ice, and see the crash into the water as the glacier tumbles in. We then come on into Ketchikan. Ketchikan is famous for totem poles. It's famous for salmon. So anytime you see John West ads, they'll be talking about the salmon that John West rejects that makes John West the best. That will be on Creek Street in Ketchikan. So originally a fishing town, still with so much rich history. There's also lumberjack shows, there's bald eagle sanctuaries, lots on offer into Ketchikan. But let's have a look. So yeah, the Butchart Garden, certainly a huge highlight for me. Over 100 years old, first started by Jenny Butchart. So her husband was in the lime business. And this now, which is known as the Sunken Garden, was the original quarry of the lime business. So Jenny continued to extend these gardens. And today to walk the beautiful Butchart Gardens is just such a wonderful experience. I mentioned the Athabasca Glacier. With Travel Marvel, you'll get to ride on the glacier. You'll walk on the glacier. You'll even get to dip your bottle into the glacier stream that runs right next to where our coaches will pull up. And this will provide you with the opportunity of drinking fresh glacier water from a glacier. And then how's this? Is there any more iconic image of Canada than the Fairmont Chateau Lake Louise? With Travel Marvel, we will be spending the night here at the Fairmont property, and you'll be treated to this stunning emerald-coloured lake fed by the Victoria Glacier. You'll get an insight into the history of the region, the flora and the fauna that makes Lake Louise such an iconic image of Canada. And talking iconic, I guess there is nothing more iconic than the Rocky Mountaineer. And really, this does show off the Canadian wilderness better than anything I experienced. To spend 2 days in the wilderness here, traveling through canyons, over bridges, beside rivers, you'll also get to see lots and lots of wildlife as you're traveling on the Rocky Mountaineer as well. So whenever we do see a bear or a bald eagle or whichever animal it might be, the train will slow right down. It's an onboard naturalist that provides a really great commentary on whichever animal we're experiencing at that time. Talking about animals, when we get into Vancouver for a couple of nights, part of your stay will include a trip out to Grouse Mountain. So with Grouse Mountain, we're going to take a cable car up to the top of the mountain, And up here, there's a number of different things that you're going to love. There's a bald eagle sanctuary. There's a lumberjack show. There's documentaries available. But the big thing here with Travel Marvel is that we'll have breakfast with the bears. So they've got a really natural enclosure where they've basically just fenced off a section of the mountain. So it's very, very natural. And these are for a few bears that unfortunately were orphaned by cars and experienced some unfortunate circumstances with their, they may have lost their mums and probably wouldn't have survived in the wild by themselves. So they're in this little sanctuary here. And with Travel Marvel, we get to come up here and have breakfast with the bears, which from our passengers' feedback is certainly one of the massive highlights of the trip. And then we always complement a tour of the Rockies with a cruise of Alaska. We'll always cruise at the end because this is a fabulous way to finish your itinerary, a great way to relax at the end. We choose to cruise with Holland America because they were the first to cruise Alaska back in 1947. And part of the benefit of that is that they get priority docking in each of the ports of Alaska, and they also get first priority to the Glacier Bay permits. They're a great size ship. 2,000 passengers is perfect. It means that you can get into the fjords of Glacier Bay, and it's also big enough to have a huge variety when it comes to restaurants, entertainment, bars, and different facilities on board the ship as well. We feel it's a great partnership between Travel Marvel and Holland America, and they're certainly a very, very important partner of Travel Marvel. Every guest with Travel Marvel gets an outside cabin. You can upgrade to the balconies if you'd like. Just before, I'll go on with our exclusive Inspiring Vacations deals. We've got save $1,800 per couple on the Rockies, Marvel and Alaska cruise. We also have 2-for-1 airfares and save a further $400 on our passage through the Rockies and Alaska cruise. But I also wanted to talk to you, and folks, if you've got any questions, please type your questions in now. I'd love to answer any of them. One question I often get is around the weather. When's it the best time of year to travel? There's a lot of different times and a lot of benefits to each of the seasons. So for me, your first criteria when you're thinking of when is a good time for you to go to the West Coast is, do you want to see as much snow as possible or do you want to see the emerald colored lakes? Because just please keep in mind, in the months of April and May, the lakes will all be frozen. So it's like a fairy tale. To see Canada with so much beautiful snow is amazing. But please keep in mind that the lakes will be frozen. Some of the walking tracks will be closed. Some of the roads may be closed. And there might be some snow, depending on the winter, in some of the valleys. June, July, and August is summer. So that's when the snow will be cracking, that it will defrost. And that's when the emerald colour will come into the water. For the first 2 weeks of July is when the Calgary Stampede is. So if you've got an interest in the Calgary Stampede, that's when we'd be able to facilitate that for you. But certainly going into that June, July and August period, temperatures might be sort of low 20s. So really consistent, great weather. Around the August, September, it's elk mating season. So lots of animals around. The nights can drop in September. So it's a little bit more inconsistent when it comes to the weather, but the day should be fine. But overnight, it could get a bit cold and you might get a light dusting of snow. When it comes to the autumn colours, if you were looking for the fall colours, you'd be identifying the East Coast to go and have a look at. And we'd be probably looking at more of the late September into October departures to truly get the essence of the autumn leaves coming in there. Canada operates on the equinox calendar, so their fall starts around about that 22 September, somewhere around there. So thanks very much, folks. It's been great to give you a small little showcase into Travel Marvel, Canada and Alaska. We really are the best value premium touring and cruise program in the market. We're very proud of our history. We're proud to be part of the APT buying group as well. So we look forward to seeing you soon. If you'd like to check out any of availability or any prices, please get in contact with Inspiring Vacations.